Okay, when I first started in my career, I absolutely hated meetings. I could barely sit through them. It just wasn't something that I wanted to do. I'd be sitting there, I would want to get out of the room, I wanted to be doing other things. It was an issue, right? But now that I've been doing this and been in 1 to 6 meetings, in-person meetings, presentations, speaking events, all kinds of different stuff for 16 years now, I've learned a lot about how to absolutely love meetings, how to get the most out of them. And today I'm going to teach you how you can love meetings and how you can crush it in meetings within your career. So let's go ahead and dive into it. Okay, so number one, the first thing that you need to know about meetings is that you need to be present, right? There's nowhere else that you need to be other than in that meeting at that time. So you sit there, you relax, you're present. You don't need to worry about anything else that's going on in the world, just right where you are right now. And if you keep that in mind, it actually makes it so that you really, really enjoy the meeting, so that you're present, so that you like being around the other people, and so that you get the most out of the meeting, and so do the other people. The other people get the most out of you. So number one is be present. Number two, this is a little bit like number one, but it's more than that. Be fully immersed in the meeting. Don't focus on yourself. Don't focus on what you're doing, but focus on the other people. Focus on the topic that's at hand. Think about ways that you can innovate and add to the conversation. So be fully immersed in the meeting and what's going on and the other people around you, listening to other people, coming up with your own ideas, chiming in at the right time. That's gonna allow you to be really successful and get the most out of the meeting and actually really enjoy it. Item number three. So this is something that one of my clients told me and it's always stuck with me. Think about every meeting going into it in your mind. Think about it like a party with your best friends, okay? You're going to see people who want to see you, who want to hang out with you, that you're great friends, and you're going in there to have a meeting with them, and it's just a little party doing what you love within your industry. If you can think about it that way and kind of position it that way in your mind, you're going to have a lot more fun. Okay, number four, don't put too much pressure on yourself. It's just a meeting. You don't need to worry about sweating. You don't need to worry about, all these things that kind of go through people's heads when they get nervous and have anxiety and stuff like that. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. Just go in there, be you, be real, and be, you know, the best that you can be, and just enjoy it. Because if you sit there and you're so worried about every little thing you do, you're not gonna get the most out of it. So all you can do in life is be you and try to be the best version of yourself. And if you do that in a meeting, then you're gonna be successful. Item five, don't focus on you. Focus on the other people in the room. You need to focus on what you're doing and how you're moving your pen, whatever. Focus on the other people in the room, what they're doing, how you can help them have the best meeting. So think about it outside of yourself. Item number six, make sure you have a goal for the meeting. With every meeting that you go into, there needs to be a main goal. What are you trying to get out of the meeting? If you don't have that, then you're gonna run into a lot of issues, and I'm gonna get into some of those other ones next. Item number seven, you need to have an agenda. What are the specific items that you're gonna be going over that help you accomplish the goal? Item number eight, have a start and end time. You don't wanna be in one of these meetings that just goes on and on and on for hours. An agenda, a specific goal, a start and an end time that's appropriate, and if you go over that, then you set up another meeting in the future. Item number nine, make sure you keep everybody on track. You're allowed to, in meetings, kind of diverge for a little bit and talk about a different topic, but if you go on long tangents that go on for 15, 20, 30 minutes or an hour, right, you start talking about something completely different, that's not good for anybody in the room, and you're not gonna accomplish the reason that you're there, the goal that you're there for, right? So make sure that you stay on track yourself and with others, and if things go on too long, more than a few minutes in the direction that doesn't make any sense, bring them back. Okay, so those are 9 things that you can do to improve your meeting experience. I just want to let everybody know, especially if you're younger, you know, usually when people start getting into meetings with older people or high power executives, you know, for me, you know, I meet with, you know, big CMOs, and that's very exciting for me. But when you're getting started, and when I was getting started back, you know, in my early 20s, and I was sitting in meetings with CEOs, because I used to work at this business magazine, you know, it's a lot, and nobody really teaches you kind of how to deal with it. So I hope that this video is helpful. I hope it can help you have great meetings. Just be real. Just be yourself. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. Think of everything like a little party. Be as present as possible, right? And just kind of, you know, zen out, look around, and try to really absorb it. And don't think about other things you need to do. That's gonna help you be really successful. And I hope you crush it in your next meeting. If you like this video, make sure to give me a like, give me a yes. I'd appreciate it. And have a good day. Bye.